Billions of years ago, Mars may have been a world not so different from Earth. Winding rivers and ancient lakes may have covered the planet's surface. Greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and water vapor were likely abundant in the atmosphere. This warm and wet climate may even have supported microscopic life, though we haven't found enough evidence to know for sure. We do know that the red planet changed significantly over time. Streams of energetic particles from the sun battered its surface, bathing Mars in radiation and stripping away its atmosphere. Liquid water vanished from the Martian surface, leaving only dry craters and riverbeds. Mars gradually became a freezing desert, but what if humans could restore the red planet to its former glory? We have long dreamt of engineering other planets to emulate Earth-like conditions, a hypothetical process called terraforming. To terraform a planet, we might alter its atmosphere or modify its ecology to make it habitable for life. Of course, achieving this goal is much more complicated than it sounds. Humans have performed similar feats on Earth, altering ecosystems and raising global temperatures. But terraforming another planet would require significant leaps in science and technology, as well as thousands of years. Assuming we can terraform another planet, the best candidate in our solar system may be one of Earth's closest neighbors, Mars. Over the last century, many have dreamt of colonizing the red planet. In their optimistic visions, brave settlers touch down on Mars and walk across its barren surface. Some remain on Mars for months or years, surviving inside sophisticated habitats and experimenting with local resources. Over time, a small settlement may expand into a flourishing colony or even the first Martian city. While this paints a pretty picture of life on Mars, the red planet poses unique dangers for anyone or anything attempting to survive on its surface. Perhaps the greatest hazard is the planet itself. The surface of Mars is an inhospitable environment, unfit for organic life. Its hostile conditions are owed in large part to the thinness of its atmosphere, which amounts to roughly 0.6% of the atmosphere on Earth. Like Earth, Mars's atmosphere contains some carbon dioxide and water vapor, especially around the planet's poles, but its atmospheric pressure is too low to retain heat and warm the surface. Temperatures on Mars have plummeted to an average of minus 65 degrees Celsius. All of its surface water has also evaporated or frozen into layers of ice. Without human intervention, Mars will likely remain a cold, inhospitable desert for the foreseeable future. To solve this problem, experts have proposed radical and ambitious solutions to develop Mars's atmosphere. Some believe we can increase its atmospheric pressure using a sizable injection of greenhouse gases. The question is where we might find an entire planet's worth of gas. Mars's red, dusty soil contains notable deposits of minerals like sulfates, silicates, and carbon compounds. Some of these minerals are buried deep underground, while others are found closer to the surface around ancient craters and riverbeds. Mining these deposits may release significant carbon stores into the atmosphere, but exactly how much carbon remains a subject of debate. According to recent estimates, Mars's shallow carbon-bearing minerals may only increase its pressure by a small percentage, not enough to terraform the entire planet. If we're looking for greenhouse gases, large quantities can be found at the red planet's poles. Mars's north and south poles are covered in thick layers of dust and water ice, which extend several kilometers deep. On top, thinner layers are created from solid carbon dioxide, also known as dry ice. Every winter, a significant portion of Mars's CO2 condenses into these layers of dry ice, causing a notable loss of atmospheric mass. When the seasons change, most of that dry ice turns back into gas, forming huge clouds that swirl around the planet's poles. However, this seasonal process only affects the thinner layers of dry ice gathered on the surface, not the thicker layers of water ice buried underneath. If we found a way to vaporize these thicker layers, we may theoretically release stores of greenhouse gases into the planet's atmosphere, but this presents another significant challenge. Melting Mars's polar caps would require a tremendous amount of heat. According to one radical theory, we could attempt to generate that heat, by detonating thermonuclear weapons above each of the planet's poles. Thermonuclear bombs use a combination of nuclear fusion and fission to create temperatures briefly exceeding 100 million degrees Celsius, almost six times hotter than the interior of the Sun. A chain of powerful explosions would ideally warm the surface of Mars. However, the nature of heat from such explosions would be very difficult to control. Moreover, maintaining this high level of heat would require us to detonate thousands of bombs every day, which is both unrealistic and ethically challenging. Another futuristic theory uses the Sun's radiation to gradually melt the red planet's icy caps. Some scientists imagine sprawling space mirrors, potentially hundreds of kilometers wide, that concentrate solar radiation onto one or both of the Martian poles. However, much of that radiation would be reflected by their white, icy surfaces. To solve this problem, dust or soot may be sprinkled across the poles to blacken the ice and increase the absorption of heat. Of course, these theories are largely untested and would require significant advances in technology. Suppose we somehow vaporize Mars's polar caps and release those stores of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Would we then have transformed Mars into a safe and hospitable world? According to recent estimates, vaporizing the ice caps may only increase the planet's atmospheric pressure from 0.6% to roughly 1.2% of the atmosphere on Earth. Even if we harvested all known carbon sinks, including shallow carbon-bearing minerals, Mars's atmosphere would still likely not be thick enough for us to survive unprotected on the surface. Mars may lack accessible natural resources needed to terraform its atmosphere, but new greenhouse gases may be generated by human industry. Scientists are experimenting with concepts for gas-producing factories, which utilize local materials to build up Mars's atmosphere. Some of these factories may produce highly potent gases, like chlorofluorocarbons, that trap substantially more heat than carbon dioxide. In theory, gas-producing factories could raise temperatures and thicken the atmosphere, but building one of these factories would be a huge challenge, not to mention the many more factories required to modify the entire planet. Even if we somehow filled Mars's atmosphere with greenhouse gases, those essential gases may be whisked away by fast-moving particles from the Sun called solar winds. Earth is protected from solar winds by a magnetosphere, a region around our planet dominated by its own magnetic field. Our magnetosphere shields our planet from harsh radiation and solar weather. It also helps our atmosphere retain important elements like oxygen and carbon. Unfortunately, Mars is not so well protected. Mars lacks a strong global magnetic field. Therefore, the surface and atmosphere are consistently exposed to solar winds. Little by little, these unobstructed particles have stripped away the planet's atmosphere and irradiated the surface. Unless we strengthen Mars's magnetic field, it may not matter how much gas we inject into its atmosphere, the planet will always remain bare. Planetary magnetic fields are generally created and maintained by the circulation of fluids through an object's core, known as a dynamo process. Billions of years ago, a dynamo process may have created a stronger magnetic field on Mars, which protected the surface from solar radiation. But Mars cooled over time. Gradually, the dynamo stopped, and its magnetic field became significantly weaker. Restarting Mars's dynamo may regenerate its magnetic field, but actually achieving this feat is far beyond our current capabilities. Instead of reaching into the deep interiors of the red planet, some theorists have suggested creating an artificial magnetic field using external technology. Speculative models describe a chain of magnets long enough to wrap around Mars that may generate a planet-wide current of charged particles. To create this magnetic chain, experts have conceptualized humongous rings of magnetic coils or large magnetic shields carefully positioned between Mars and the Sun. These structures would catch and absorb radiation, protecting Mars from devastating solar events, but these designs are purely theoretical. With time and technological growth, humanity may one day make progress toward terraforming Mars. Should our optimistic visions of Martian life come true, we may eventually create a hospitable world where water flows on the surface and durable plants grow in the soil. Farther in the future, Martian settlers may take off their pressurized suits and for the first time, walk unprotected on the surface. Between then and now, the scientific and logistical hurdles are incredibly daunting. While terraforming is a popular concept, we still don't know if changing Mars on a planetary scale is realistic or even possible. But if we can somehow re-engineer the Red Planet, our dreams of living on Mars may finally be within our reach.